In this quick tutorial, let's look at how to prepare a jump shot. Basically, a jump shot is two footages recorded simultaneously on two different devices, and you want to play back both tracks simultaneously while having the flexibility of switching between tracks, because they both are shot at the same time. So the audio would be in sync, and you have flexibility to jump between two different angles, such as zoom in, zoom out, or if two people talking to each other, one camera facing one person and the other one facing the other person, you can switch between the jump shots. So yeah, so in this case, I have shot a small video, my son drawing a dinosaur on two different cam. One is an iPhone XR that is on the bottom track, and another video track on Samsung Galaxy phone. So that is on track V2. So if we look at it, this is shot on 1080p, and the other one, which is at the bottom, shot on iPhone XR 4K quality. They both are kind of aligned, but not a perfect sync aligned. What it means is that unless they have audio playing exactly at the same time, both shots are not meant for jump shot. Practically, you can do it. You can take a clip which is shot in a different time and put it as a jump shot, as long as the scene matches. But it is more realistic if you align both tracks by their absolute timestamp, and then do cutover shots so that it would be more natural between the flow. So to identify or to arrange the tracks at the right timestamp, if you are not using clapping technique, there is an alternative way you can do it. One, first turn off the upper track by clicking on the hide icon and then mute the icon, so that what you see is only the bottom track. Let's identify a position in which you feel more connected. Let's assume in this shot, in the below shot, I want to stop at a position which is more easily capturable. For example, here is, I'm pointing a finger, then here he is making a mark on the paper with his finger, which is a couple of half a point second into the action. So that is at this position. Now I need to move this track around that point to make both of them sync. But the problem is, as soon as you start playing the above track, the cursor head would be moving around. And to mitigate the risk, what you can do is, you can add a dummy track in between. Like in this case, I added a V2. I can call it a marker track. What we can do is, we have many options to create some basic markers. I remember doing some kind of flagging in some previous versions, but I don't seem to find that option anymore for time being. iPhone red mark on paper. Just a text pointer I added here. It is coming, so I just insert it on the V2 marker track. Okay, the purpose of this marker is not to show this text on the screen, but to make this cursor position on iPhone track easily identifiable, which is the starting of this text. For example, if I move somewhere here and I am identifying track's position on Samsung, for example, I open Samsung track and I move around. Now, to go back on iPhone, the exact point where we want to start the sync process, I can double click on this track, the header would move to that absolute position, which is nothing but the, you know, red mark on the paper, right? That is the advantage of this transparent or whatever marker track. Now, since we know exactly where our header is, let's work on Samsung track to position. I think there is a, this one ripple effect is in place. Let me remove that. Let me lock these two just to be sure. And yeah, let's move Samsung track until we identify the exact frame. See, here it comes. He's putting his finger on the paper. And let's move one frame out above and one more. Probably this is the best time. We can readjust by a fraction of a second here and there. But we know exactly this is where it is. So if you hold this track somewhere here, you would lose this position, right? You hold this and you start moving, you miss the point where it, where the position is. So to mitigate that, you have two options. One, to cut the frame here and move pieces one by one, first this and then second part. But more easily you can identify, look at the cursor, it's a hand symbol. Move your hand to the center finger, overlapping the arrowhead, click. Track is selected at a position which is approximately the pointer where we identified the frame. Now start moving it, moving left or right, whatever. The track is moving relative to the position where you started. So let's assume the below transparent track is the marker where we want to position the track. And now I'm holding the clip at a position where the Samsung clip is also in sync. So let me release it. Hopefully they both should be in sync, but if not, let's adjust a little bit. So let me put my cursor header there by double clicking it. Now let me zoom in a bit. Bring all frames to the center. Let's look at the audio track, audio waveform between these two tracks, right? That is the best match which will give you. See, here there are three peaks, one, two, three. They are slightly off. And any other better clue? Yeah, this one. The header here and one peak here, they both are off by a second or less than that. And there is another peak. So we are almost there. So let's, since we locked this position, below position, let adjust the above track. If you want to move the track by milliseconds delay, hold the Alt key on the keyboard and then start moving. Let's say somewhere here, they both appear to be overlapping, right? Okay, if you want, you can remove the dummy track because that is not needed. Now you have both tracks in sync. Let me take a peek. Let's listen to the audio and see if they both are in absolute sync. Both are enabled, both are visible.
Okay, don't worry.
Let me switch between the tracks. Here he's painting the neck. And from different angle is also. Right? Yeah, so the audio is in sync and the clips appear to be almost in synchronization. Let's move a little forward and ensure the peaks are in sync. Yeah. Even here, the both peaks are in sync. Now, since the audio is almost in sync by only a margin of milliseconds, you can confidently start creating jump shots. I'll just give one or two examples probably you can work on it at your convenience. For example, in this case, okay, at this point, he's drawing it. I want to take a front shot at this point. So what I'll do, I'll take a cut on the Samsung track and cut until this point. Okay, until he moves the dinosaur. I take another cut here. Then I'll lift. Okay. I usually not comfortable removing the clips because I may need that at some point later. So what I do instead, I switch on to a track which is not visible so that you still get, you know, this is hidden. So at this point, the layer would be picked up by the iPhone. So let's look at the jump shot sequence. Here, it's coming from the Samsung shot. And here, I'm switching to iPhone. And again, I'm switching back to the Samsung track. Okay? So at this point, I want to... if you want a sham, the upper track to be the primary visible, you don't need to do anything because the below track is obviously overridden, overlapped by this one. So you don't really need to do any cuts on the iPhone track and remove the clips. But since there are two layers, two video layers rendering at the same time, it is not process efficient. Even when exporting, a couple of times I noticed some lag in the place where there are multiple video tracks running simultaneously. So I would recommend, if there is a place where you want to take a jump shot on the below, I would highly recommend do a cut and then, you know, take the clip off onto a track which is not visible so that, you know, you continue to have the actual track which is running on primary and the secondary is not in processing scope when exporting, right? So that's what the advantage. And also I can do the clip edit here. So I'll go here. Here also this is not needed. I can move this track onto the different track. And then, yeah, that's how you do jump shots and when the recording happened on multiple devices. Let me do a final cut. And at this point, I want to have iPhone track rather than this one. So that it gives a good example. So let me finally look how it would look like. So here, this is iPhone shot. And this is Samsung shot. Then switching on the camera and then further here, switching back to the primary track. Yep. I hope you like this tutorial. Let me know in comments if you have any other suggestions or any other queries on this particular video. Thank you.